been in an accident. There's people hurt.
You're in an accident? Where are you located?
By Gull High School, we're on 8th Street, next to the parking lot by the football field.
Okay. And how many vehicles are involved?
There's two.
There's two vehicles? And is there any injuries?
There is.
Have either one of you been drinking?
I've been drinking.
You've been drinking? Were you the driver?
Yes.
Okay, do you know how much you've had to drink?
I was at a party, I had a good amount of drinks.
Okay, you were at a party and had a good amount of drinks? And what about Alexis? Has she been drinking?
I'm pretty sure,
yeah. I'm pretty sure, okay. And the other two people in the other car, you said they're still moving right now?
Yeah, they're injured though.
Okay, have they gone out of your vehicle?
Thank you. Well, you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go. Only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hate the road when you're missing home. Only know you love her when you let her go. And you let her go. Staring at the bottom of your glass, hoping one day you'll make a dream last. But dreams come slow and they go so fast. You see it when you close your eyes. Maybe one day you'll understand why. Everything you touch surely dies.
Your son was just brought in by ambulance. It sounds like it was a pretty severe car crash. Has some pretty significant bone fractures that we can know about. We're in the process of getting x-rays. At this point, my biggest concern, however, is that he may be paralyzed. He's not moving anything below his, basically below his legs aren't moving, and he doesn't really feel a whole lot below his belly button. So, got the CAT scan of the head and the rest of her body. Her brain injury is very severe. Our neurosurgeons don't think there's anything that they can do neurologically or surgically to fix it. It's very loose. It doesn't look like there's a lot of blood flow to the brain at this point on the CAT scan. We haven't done a formal brain death exam yet. My name is David Fox, and I'm from Sierra Donor Services. And what we're involved in patients like Adelaide, we talk to the families after brain death has been declared. We talk about the option of saving many lives through organ and tissue donation. I'd like to present that to you right now and just see what your feelings are as far as perhaps saving some lives through donation.
I want to do that for sure.
Sure. Good.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
Well, what's gonna happen over the next day or so? Natalie is gonna stay on the ventilator. She's gonna stay on some machines to keep her organs functioning, and then we will be on site here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to work with Natalie and then find a suitable person that can receive her organs, the gift she's giving to someone else to save their lives. And that time, you'll be able to stay here on site with her. You'll be able to bring your family in here. And then over the next couple of days, we'll find the right recipients for that.
Stories that I can't explain. Leave my heart open, but it stays right here empty for days.
Hi. Keep on.
She told me in the morning she don't feel the same about us.
Okay.
Seems to me that when I die, these words will be written on my story. And I'll be gone tonight. The ground beneath my feet is open wide. The way that I've been holding on too tight, with nothing in between. The story of my life, I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm. The story of